To explain further, we're going to go to a report with our very own Scott Hartkorn. But first, we're going to go to a sideline report with our very own Scott Hartkorn, with our very own Scott Hartkorn. Take it away, Scott.
Thanks, Fran. I'm standing outside of City Hall where there was a major buzz about the inaugural Mayor's Cup game. Inside, Mayor Michael Nutter, Coach Golden, and Coach Talley all were there to unveil the Mayor's Cup trophy. Now we're going to take a look at the press conference.
All right, thanks, Fran. I'm standing here now with tight end Steve Mineri. And Steve, how are the tight ends doing so far this training camp?
The tight ends are doing really well. There's a lot of athletes, a lot more athletes this year than we had in the past years. We have Alex Jackson, Evan Rodriguez, two guys that are really fast and, you know, a lot more athletic than me. And
now that you're a senior on defense, what is your role this year?
Be more of a vocal leader. I used to lead by example. Now I got to do it just by putting out another voice.
After four successful years, Temple's defense's most valuable player looks to achieve his lifelong goal of reaching the NFL and to be the first Owl drafted since Ryan Wallace in 2005. Reporting for Temple Update, I'm Scott Hartkorn.
It was easy for these young Owls to see what their coach expected of them.
That's it now. Out tough, out finish, and out play.
Along the way, these young Owls learned to do something that had seemed so hard to accomplish in the past. Win.
Win on me, win on through! 1, 2, 3, win!
There were still many reasons to celebrate. The 2010 season saw the torch passed to a group of hungry young players who flourished in new roles.
Going long, completes to Rod Streeter.
But the Owls also leaned on a group of veterans who led with intensity, a senior class that will forever be known for leaving a legacy.
We just wanted to make sure we take it one step at a time. If you want to be the champs, you must beat the champs.
Their first test placed them in a battle for the Mayor's Cup against crosstown rival Villanova, a team the Owls knew could not be taken lightly. Temple did not take long to please the crowd of over 32,000.
He is going to link hits to Brown, and now reverse his field. He got a block at the 20. He could go in at the 10, 5, yes! Touchdown, Matt Brown.
Whenever Matt Brown runs, it's exciting because he's so small, so people underestimate him already. But whenever he's on that field, it's exciting to see him running.
Drops back across midfield, has time. Looks, now rolls out to his left. Being chased over there by Mohammed Wilkerson. Throws, and it is picked off. The Owls come up with the interception.
The Wildcats fought back. And with Temple now down by 5, the offense needed to make a play.
Play action to Brown, looks to throw, has time, down the middle, Campbell open, he's got it, he's going to go, 5, touchdown, Michael Campbell!
You know, I see Chester and Mike always practicing, especially during camp, spending extra hours when everybody else is leaving, and it finally paid off in the game.
The celebration was short-lived, however, when Villanova took the lead back with just over 2 minutes left on the clock.
First thing I told myself was that we was not going to lose like last year. And then I spoke to the rest of the offensive line as we was going on the field. Their mindset was the same as my mindset, so I knew we was going to win because we was all on the same page.
0 timeouts remaining, 1:43 left on the game clock. Here's Stewart to throw again. Throws to the sidelines. Campbell's got it. Races out of bounds. First down. Stewart to Bernard Pierce. Dances for the first down. He's got it. 52 seconds, a lot of time. Stewart pumps, rolls, sets up. Now he's going to run. He's being chased. He's at the 40, angles to the sidelines, and he is out of bounds.
Line him up with 16, 15. Stewart looks to throw over to the sidelines, and out of bounds goes Brown at the 25. That stops the clock with 8.
Brandon McManus, who already had connected on 3 field goals, calmly walked out to attempt the game winner.
From the left hash from Charlton's hole, Brandon McManus, a 42-yarder to win it. Here's the placement. Kick is on its way. It's long enough. And the kick is good. The kid's done it. Brandon McManus with his 4th field goal of the night.
On the ensuing kickoff, it was Justin Gilday
that would put the game away.
Oh, oh no! It's all over. Yes. Brandon McManus, the hero of the night, and the Owls come back. Wow, just a great game.
And above all, this class will be remembered for setting a standard, starting a tradition, and for leaving their legacy.
Kill y'all with kindness, I kill ya, my natural persona.